Dear students, welcome to my class. I am Big Balanchin, lecturer of English, Bandarban Cantonment Public School and College. Dear students, today I am here before you to conduct a class for you on your English second paper on topic narration. Students, in my last class yesterday, I discussed on the use of tense in narrations because you know it's very important to know tense well, use of tense well, because you need to change the tense of the speech or any speech or a sentence when you change it from direct to indirect or from indirect to direct. This is very important. So in my last class yesterday, I discussed in detail everything about the use of tense narration. In today's class, I'd like to show you some exceptions when you don't need to change tense, when you change any speech or a sentence from direct to indirect forms. These are the exceptions. So you must know and learn this. Many of these rules, many of you must know, but let's see. Discuss in details so that every one of you can be clear of the exceptions. So now let's start this. You see, the topic narration, rules of narration, use of tense in narration. When not to change tense while changing speech from direct into indirect. Direct into indirect. So let's see. So sentence number one, he said, I had done the work. Past perfect tense. When you use or you see, you find past perfect tense used in a statement or in a speech, you don't need to change the tense. When you change the speech from direct to indirect, he said that he had done the work. I will change the tense of the sentence. So remember, when the tense of a statement or sentence or a speech within the inverted commas in direct narration is past perfect tense, you don't need to change the tense when you change the speech or sentence into indirect narration. Question 2, he said, I had been reading since morning, past perfect continuous tense. When there is past perfect continuous tense in direct narration, the tense doesn't change when you change the speech or sentence into indirect narration. So he said, I had been reading since morning. In indirect narration, he said that he had been reading since morning. No change of tense. Question 3, he said, I was planning. The indirect narration, he said that he was planning. It is a past continuous tense. We know that generally, according to the rule of grammar, past continuous tense changes into past perfect continuous tense, but here it's exception because the planning, I was planning, doesn't refer to or doesn't indicate any completed action. Understand? If you say, he said, I was planning to go to Boxes Bazar, but I changed my plan. Here, starting from he was planning to go to Boxes Bazar to change the plan, refers to completed action. So you could change in this case. In this case, you can write, he said that he had been planning to go to Boxes Bazar, but he had changed his plan according to the rule. But when a verb doesn't indicate to any completed action, the tense in case of past continuous tense only, please, the tense will change from when you change it from direct to indirect. So he said I was planning, he said that he was planning. Okay. Question number 4, he says I like reading books, he says that I like reading books. When still remember that. So the indefinite tense should change in the past indefinite tense according to the rules. But when the reporting verb is in present indefinite tense, the tense of the reported speech in direct narration doesn't change when you change the speech or sentence into indirect narration. Remember that. Question number 5, he said, I went home to bath and ate lunch. The past indefinite tense, according to rules of grammar, we know that past indefinite tense changes into past perfect tense, but let's see the indirect form of the sentence. He said that he went home to bath and ate lunch. No change of tense. Why? Because if there are only one verb, in sense of past indefinite tense, for example, he said I went home, In this case, you can change it into, he said that he had gone from past indefinite to past perfect. But when there are two or more verbs at the same time, you don't need to change the tense of the sentence. This is the rule of grammar, remember these sections. So, he said, I went home, took bath, ate lunch, three verbs together. And in direct narration, he said that he went home, took bath, and ate lunch, the change of the tense. Sentence number six, he said, honesty is the best policy. In case of any universal truth, tense are changed. Or if I say the sun rises in the east, he said, the sun rises in the east, he said that the sun rises in the east. In case of universal truth, tense of the direct narration or the reverse speech doesn't change. So question number 7, he said Bangladesh becomes independent in 1997. In historical fact, you can either change it into past indefinite tense or you can keep it or write it in a present indefinite tense. That means you don't need to change the tense. He said Bangladesh becomes independent in 1997. Yeah, 71, sorry. He said, Bangladesh becomes independent in, incongruences here happened. Let me correct it. He said that for lack of space, I have written here. He said that BD, in case Bangladesh, Bangladesh became independent in 1971. So it's right perfect, so no change of time. The question right, he said, I could go home tomorrow. Can put name, my child should, these are modal auxiliary verb. A premolar verb or modal auxiliary, the verb or tense, the tense of the verb doesn't change. So, he said, I could go home tomorrow, direct narration. When I change it into direct narration, it is tense. He said that he could go home the next day. No change of the verb, principal verb here. Because could remain could, it doesn't change because it's a modal verb. And after modal verb, any verb that will change is tense. Remember that, in case of use of modal verb. In question of 9, he said, it is high time. We did the work. It is time or it is high time. After D, we always use subject plus V to plus object. But here, there are two verbs. It is high time. It is here. We did. There are two verbs in the sentence. Remember, it is time or it is high time. In this case, in this part, is can be changed. But we did the work here. The verb did in the second part doesn't change, it remains the same. Remember that, please. He said, it is high time we did the work. In the indirect narration, he said that it was high time they did the work. If you don't know, you would change the did the work past indefinite tense into they had done the work past perfect tense. No, it's not according to the rules. You don't need to change, you're going to change the tense of this. No, the second part of the sentence. In that case, question 10, he said, I used to play cricket in the childhood. Used to, if you look at the verb, you think it's a past indefinite tense. You see, subject plus is to doesn't change when you change from direct to indirect narration. Remember, he said that he used to play in direct narration, he said, I used to play cricket in the childhood. Did mention in direct. He said that he used to play cricket in the childhood. You see, subject plus is to doesn't change. I haven't changed it here. Then students, these are some exceptions in the use of tense in narration. These are very important for you. So I think I will make the best use of this class, the information, learn them. And for some more exceptions, uncommon rules of grammar with narration, please go through the pages of the textbook, page from 132 to 138 here in the SW. And those who already know well, who have good command over tense and narration, you could do what you could do. You could you find out standard narrations from your from the textbooks and work on them. You may find it from the question paper of test exams of different colleges of 2019. Please. I'm at the end of my class, students. Thank you very much for watching this class with attention. I hope you'll make the best use of this class. I thank you again. Allah Hafiz.